story earlier from New York and the East Coast about a storm, and I just mentioned during the commercial break that I want one blizzard, and then I'm good for the rest of the winter.
Howard wants a blizzard. I want some thunderstorms. I think I'll win this one. We'll likely get some storms, but no blizzard just yet. Right. I can get you colder temperatures and some gusty winds. I'll likely take that for the deal. But today really hasn't been bad. Been more like a spring day rather than winter. We saw temperatures again this morning in the 40s. Slowly warmed up really only into the low 50s. And we're actually going to see those temperatures increase through the night. We're seeing a warm front that's going to push on through. And that's going to allow our temperatures tomorrow actually to be well above normal across much of the eastern U.S. From Pittsburgh all the way to Springfield to Wichita to Des Moines, even here in Indy. Good chance to see those temperatures 31 degrees above average, but right behind that, though, that's going to bring us our change. So Grand Island, 7 degrees below average, even Rapid City, 15 degrees below average tomorrow. With this big swing of temperatures, it's going to be a strong cold front that moves on through. We'll see the return of some showers, even a few thunderstorms, any which could be on the low end, strong to severe scale. Storm Prediction Center does have the entire area under a marginal risk. That's a 1 out of 5 on the severe weather scale. So, whole state of Indiana can't rule out some gusty winds, some small hail, and some heavy downpours. Now, that tornado risk, not 100% zero, though my confidence in that is relatively high that that chance is low. So, that's likely not 100% out of the picture, but if we're going to see anything, it's more so going to be gusty winds, and even outside of storms, still will have to deal with those gusty winds as well. So by 5 p.m. tomorrow, across the state, we see those gusts of generally 30 to 35, and through the overnight hours, we see that really start to pick up. So it's going to get breezy along with the storms, so by midnight, gusts across the area, at least 35 to 40 miles per hour, and anywhere you see these pink magenta shades, good chance we could even see some localized gusts, even 45 to 50 plus, and through the day Monday. We notice the gusts still remaining through the morning hours, but into the afternoon, we start to see it die down a little bit, where we'll see some gusts generally of 20 to 30 miles per hour. So outside of storms, still going to notice things gusty. Going to notice temperatures actually start to fall behind the front, but at least for now, we're about 51 here in Indy. Still is cool though, 43 to Richmond, 57 to Bloomington. But through the night, those temperatures are actually going to rise. We're seeing a warm front work on through right now. So everyone across the board, as we get past midnight, we're back into the 50s. Even by sunrise tomorrow, we're back into the 60s. And that's going to be accompanied by some showers. Going to take a little bit to start to see those storms work in. So by midnight, it's just going to be mostly cloudy. We'll see these isolated light showers. Through the morning hours, along and north of I-70, we'll see that coverage start to pick up a little bit. Spots up towards Lafayette, Kokomo. Can't 100% rule out a couple rumbles of thunder, but better chance for that comes later on in the day towards the evening. But through much of the day, it's just going to be these light showers and cloudy skies. But towards 5 p.m., we see the cold front that's going to start to swing on through. So at least by that 6 to 8 p.m. time frame, this is when we're going to have to watch for those strong, severe storms to work through. But by 10 p.m., we actually see those storms out of the area, and it's just going to be more so cloudy, but can't 100% rule out a few snowflakes, maybe a brief light snow shower. So it's a two-edged sword. We start off with severe storms, and then it's going to get cold. So by 9 p.m. tomorrow, we're still in the 50s and 60s, but as that front comes through, those temperatures start to crash behind it. So by morning commute on Monday, easily seeing those temperatures down to the 20s, so we'll have to watch that risk for refreeze first thing Monday morning, with most of the day in the 20s. Tuesday, though, we stay in the 20s, but we see the sunshine return. Wednesday into Thursday, weak little clipper moves on through, so can't 100% rule out a few snow showers, but generally in the 20s and 30s, as we finish out the week and head into next weekend as well. Howard,